So we left off in part one, getting pretty close to finding our n of t that satisfies the logistic differential equation, where its initial condition is between 0 and k. And now we just have to really just do some algebra to finish things up. So we left with this, that for our n of t, this must be true. Now we could use a little bit of logarithm properties to rewrite this left-hand side as the logarithm of, if I have the logarithm of something minus the logarithm of something else, that's going to be the first something, the logarithm of the first something divided by the second something. 1 minus n over k, and this is of course going to be equal to all this business that we have. It's going to be equal to, actually let me just write it. It's going to be equal to r times t plus c. And now what we could do, this is the same thing as saying that e to the rt plus c is going to be equal to this thing right over here. This the natural log of this is equal to the exponent that I have to raise e to get to this right over here. So I can just write that. We could just write, or another way of thinking about it is we could take e to, if this is equal to that, we could take e to this power on the left-hand side and e to this power on this right-hand side, and they should be equal. So e to this power is just going to be what's inside the parentheses. It's just going to be n over 1 minus n over k. And I'll do that in green color so you can just keep track of where things came from. Is equal to e to this business. Is equal to e to the r, I'll do the t in white, rt plus c. Now, this I could rewrite if I want to. If I have e to something plus something else, I could rewrite this as to the rt times e to the c. And just to simplify things, this is just going to be another constant here. And I could, you know, if this is c, I could call it c1, but I'm just going to call that a constant. So I could just say that that's going to be equal to some constant times e to the rt. And now we just need to solve for n. And once again, if at any point while we're working on this, you get inspired, feel free to solve for n. So let's see, one way to solve for n, let's see if we could take the reciprocal of both sides of this, we're going to get one, let me draw a line here just so you know that we're, so let me draw a line. So if we take the reciprocal of both sides of this, we're going to get 1 minus n over k over light green n is equal to, and so let's, you know, we could say it's equal to 1 over c times e to the negative rt, but 1 over c, that's just going to be another constant. So I could write 1 over c here when I take the reciprocal, but once again, this is just going to be another constant, so I'm going to be a little bit hand-wavy. He says, well, okay, we're going to get another constant here. I could have called, you know, this c1, this c2, I could call this c3 if I want, to make it clear that these are not going to be the same number. This is e to this power, this is the reciprocal of that. Actually, maybe I'll do that just to make it a little bit clearer. That would have been c1 right over there. And so this is going to be, sorry, the reciprocal of this is c3, and e to the negative, the reciprocal of e to the rt is e to the negative rt, e to the negative rt. And let's see, if we divide the numerator and the denominator by n, or if we divide, one way to think about it, we divide this term by n, we're going to get, so this term by n is going to be 1 over n, and then this term by n is just going to be minus 1 over k. So this is just going to be minus 1 over k is equal to this business. So copy and paste. It's going to be equal to that. This is good algebra practice here. Now let's see, we could take this 1 over k, add it to both sides. So let's do that. So let me just cut. Cut and paste it. I'm going to add it to both sides. So that should be a plus 1 over k. So plus 1 over k. And now to solve for n, I just take the reciprocal of both sides. So I'm going to get n, and I'll write it in kind of the function notation, n of t Actually, let me make my t in white since I've been taking the trouble all this time of rewriting this in white, is equal to 1 over, is going to be equal to 1 over all of this business, is going to be equal to 1 over all of this business. So copy and paste is going to be equal to that. And that by itself is already interesting. That by itself is already interesting. So I could write it like this. And if I want, if I don't like, let's see. Well, yeah, I could just, if I don't like having this k, you know, kind of a fraction in a fraction, I could rewrite it as, actually, maybe I'll do it over here. N of t is equal to, I'll just multiply the numerator and the denominator by, I'll just multiply it. Actually, let me just leave it like that for now. And what I'm going to do, what I'm now going to do is I'm going to say, well, look, you know, we're assuming that n of 0 is n sub naught. So we're assuming that n of 0 is equal to n sub naught. So let's write this thing. Let's solve for the constant. Let's figure out what this could be if we know what our initial condition is. So n of 0 is going to be equal to, it's going to be equal to 1 over, when t is 0, this is just going to be equal to 1. So it's going to be our constant C3 plus 1 over k plus 1 over the maximum population that our population, that our environment can handle. And that's going to be equal to n naught. And now we can solve for our constant. So we get, actually, I'm probably going to need a lot of real estate for this. I can take the reciprocal of both sides again. So this is something that we're doing a lot of. C3 plus 1 over k is equal to 1 over n naught. It is equal to 1 over n naught. Just took the reciprocal of both sides. And so we get our constant, C3 is equal to 1 over n naught minus 1 over k. Minus 1 over k. And so we can rewrite our solution, which we'll call the logistic function. We get, this is fun now. N of t is equal to 1 over, our constant is this. So it's going to be, let me copy and paste this. So copy and paste. It's going to be that. That's our constant. So it's going to be that times e to the negative rt to the negative r times t plus 1 over k. Plus 1 over k. And if we don't like having all of these denominators in the all of these fractions in the denominator, why don't we multiply everything times the numerator and the denominator by n naught k? So I'm going to multiply the numerator times n naught k, and I'm going to multiply the denominator by n naught k. And so what do we get? This is all going to be equal to, in the numerator, I have n naught times k. And in the denominator, I am going to have, let's see, if I multiply this term right over here times n naught k, I'm going to have k. If I multiply this term times n naught k, I'm going to have n naught. So it's going to be minus n naught times e to the negative rt times e to the negative rt. Negative rt. And then if I multiply this times n naught k, I'm going to get n naught. So plus n naught. And there you have it. We have found a solution for the logistic differential equation. We will call this the logistic function. And in future videos, we will explore it more, and we will see that it actually does. If you were to plot this, and I encourage you to do so, either on the internet, you could try Wolfram-Alpha, if you're on your graphing calculator, you will see that it has the exact properties that we want it to have. It starts at n naught, it starts to increase at increasing rates, but then it starts to slow down as we reach our maximum population. And so that is actually a very neat function. If you model a population with this, you can kind of start to make predictions about what might the population be at time, you know, whatever. And so hopefully you found that satisfying.